Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Laskion Corlin. Taoiseach, I think you're well aware, as we all are, that there have been many companies across Ireland that have made workers redundant, given the broader economic context and collapse that we're working in. But I think we've all been made aware of two very high-profile companies in recent weeks, such as Lagan Brick in Drumgill and Vita Cortex in Cork. We do know that 29 Lagan Brick workers were not even given 30 days' notice in December last when they were made redundant. However, my understanding is they've agreed to go to the Labour Court, and we hope that that process will have a successful outcome. The situation pertaining to Vita Cortex workers, however, is one of complete limbo and very considerable difficulty. You met them yourself last Friday, and they were grateful for that. And there's cross-party agreement, I think, in the House that the workers in this company have been treated appallingly by the company itself. In total, they've given over 847 years of loyal service, and they were told bluntly in December that they would not be receiving any ex gratia redundancy payments, despite being promised it in September. And they have been in a sit-in situation ever since the December the 16th. I think we're all agreed they've, in essence, been deserted by their employer. And the net amount that's outstanding and at stake at this stage is about 372,000 workers, or pound, euros. 372,000 euros would resolve this. And it is, there are complications in terms of the relationship of the company and the owner with NAMA. But clearly the moral responsibility is with the owner. I want to make that very clear, and we're agreed on that. And the initial Labour Relations Commission intervention was unfortunately unsuccessful in January, and that is suspended. That's the situation now, given the fact that they're potentially the workers are facing legal action from the employers in relation to the sit-in, is particularly worrying for the workers and their families. Taoiseach, I want to ask you at this stage, and I do so in the spirit of agreement across parties, notwithstanding all of the interventions to date, whether you would consider, whether yourself or the Minister for Enterprise would meet with the owner of the company to first of all convey the view of the Oireachtas that the behaviour has been unacceptable, and also to see if some way can be developed or formulated to bring a resolution to this situation in the interests of all concerned.
Thank you.
Whether it's to reinitiate the LRC's intervention or to, on behalf of everybody here, convey from the executive our absolute disgust with what's happening and to have the matter resolved in the interests of the workers.
Taoiseach.
Well, to respond to Deputy Martin's valid question here, I'd like to pay tribute to the life and work of the late John Cunningham, who was the editor of the Connacht Tribune, as you know, for very many years, editor of Tuam, who was a person who understood really the changing face of Ireland and articulated that with great truth and courage. I called to see him some time ago, spent some time in his presence. He was a gentleman and somebody who loved his job in terms of his editorial responsibility. And so to Deputy Martin, your question raises lots of issues about moral responsibility, the law, the situation insofar as workers are concerned, their rights, the law and firms. Now, I met with Ms. Eager, the union representative, and a number of workers in Cork last week, as Deputy Martin's aware. And the thing that struck me about the Vita Cortex workers, as you point out, that they've given several hundred years service accumulatively, and their words to me was that it was respect is what they wanted to be shown, and fairness in respect of all other workers who left the Vita Cortex plants in various places around the country. All others received 2.9 weeks. What's on offer here were 2 weeks. Now, in the beginning, when this happened and the workers stayed in over Christmas and are now over 50 days in occupation of the plant, Minister Bruton made his own officials aware, available to talk to the trade union representatives, clarify a number of matters there. Invited the Labour Relations Commission to get involved here with both sides. There were two meetings and they didn't proceed beyond that point. The Director of Corporate Enforcement, the Office of the Director of Corporate Enforcement, informed the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise that he didn't consider the information that was available to him. You may have been in receipt yourself of the correspondence. Consider the information in his possession about the claims of the capacity of this company to make available the extra 374,000. But he said in response to Minister Bruton that he had considered that information, that he had taken legal advice on it, and that he was satisfied that he had insufficient grounds to take any formal action against the company at this time on the basis of his assessment of the claim that this company, Vita Cortex, and its owner were in a position to pay out the extra 0.9 weeks, which amounted to 374,000. Now, as I say, Deputy, a lot of people are watching this case with a degree of interest. I feel for these workers. They're very decent people. And what annoys me is that they did facilitate the company in having specialist equipment and sophisticated equipment moved out of that plant, allegedly for overhaul and for repair, but which was allowed to leave the plant. And they did so on the specific understanding that when all of this would be over, that they would be compensated properly, and by that they mean in respect of equivalent of what everybody else got. Now, I spoke to, had a meeting with Minister Bruton yesterday. It's a very difficult situation. I believe that we should continue to exhaust all of the machinery here, first of all. It's not nice to have these workers sitting in this plant feeling very aggrieved because of what's happened here. Minister Burton's department has processed the statutory redundancy payments, and I understand they will be paid next Monday. And obviously the state moved in to do that in respect of the workers. So I think, Deputy, what I intend to do is to give a report to the Labour Relations Commission arising from my meeting with the workers and their union representatives, to invite the Commission to get involved here again before I would consider any further action arising from your request directly. I do feel for these workers. As you rightly point out, there's a moral responsibility here. But the Office of the Director of Corporate Enforcement has informed the Minister for Jobs and Enterprise that he has insufficient grounds in his possession to take action against the company.
Dr. Micheál Martin, 1 minute supplementary.
Thank you, Askin Coulon. I too, of course, would pay tribute to the late John Cunningham and convey our sympathies to his wife, Nuala, and family, and obviously we'll be paying a fuller tribute later. To say, Taoiseach, I welcome your response, and I think all of the deputies in the Cork region met across party with the workers on Monday, and there's uniformity of view in terms of support for the workers' position and getting the situation resolved. But I would ask you first of all, I would welcome the in this initiative to get the LRC involved again. Secondly, I would make the point that I'm conscious that not all workers have achieved the same profile in terms of the issue, but I do think the Vita Cortex situation, and indeed Lagan Bricks and King's Court, illustrate a growing development and phenomenon in terms of layoffs and so on. And it does perhaps call into question the need to review the mechanisms that we currently have. Are they fit for purpose for these specific situations, particularly where you have a complication with an AMA dimension and involvement as well? I think that's worth, in the broader sense, reviewing. In terms of the immediate situation with Vita Cortex, I would ask you to keep within your frame, if you like, and a frame of reference, the possibility of a direct intervention by the Minister at some stage to convey, if you like, on behalf of the political community, our anger with what has happened, and our strongest sense that it's unacceptable in relation to the workers themselves. And I think many people are watching this as an illustrative situation that informs other situations that may develop, and indeed some that have, but people have had to move on and have been in a position perhaps to maintain a campaign of the kind that has been maintained here over the last 50 days or so. I think we're all agreed that this is not an acceptable way to treat workers in our society, and we expect better. And that obviously you're anxious that all existing mechanisms be used to try and bring a resolution to this. That's fair enough. But I think over and above that, I think all other possibilities should be.
Margaret, Taoiseach, 1 minute.
To acknowledge your point there, Deputy Martin, might I just say, in respect of the statutory redundancy, the Department of Social Protection and the Minister moved in here because of the claim that the employer was not able to pay. Obviously, where an employer has funds, they must, they're duty bound to meet the employee's statutory entitlement. There can be no question of the sort of the state making that and the employer coming back and making a top-up payment. But just for the information of the House, the dispute now rests really with relates to the non-statutory payment of 0.9 of a week's pay per year of service, which, as you pointed out, amounts to 372,000. So where workers have actually supplied bank account details, the money will be lodged to their accounts in the week commencing the 13th of February, having been processed by the Department of Social Protection. Where bank accounts were not provided, payment of the lump sums will be made by cheque, and cheque payments should also issue during the week of the 13th of February. I understand from the Labour Relations Commission that the solicitors acting on behalf of Vita Cortex have in recent days written to SIPTU, indicating that they may look at the question of an injunction against the workers who continue to occupy the factory. Now, as I say, I'd like to see this brought to a successful conclusion. Reputation is very important for everybody. I found these workers, of all the workers I've met in many cases over the years, to be understanding that this is a difficult position, but they have a really deep feeling that they should deserve respect from an employer in respect of whose business they've given, in some cases, up to 47 years loyal and dedicated and committed service. So I've informed the Labour Relations Commission of my meeting with the workers and the trade union representative, the outcome of that, and ask them to get involved again. And I've taken note of what you said besides, Deputy.
Good, Margaret. Before I call Deputy Allen, could I just join in the expression of sympathy to the Cunningham family and the death of John Cunningham. He actually wrote under the pen name The Deputy in the Connacht Tribune. Deputy Gerry Adams, your question, please.